Hello, my people out there. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. So today's topic is a viewer requested topic, that is, what is LTA? Okay, someone has requested me to make the video on this topic, like what exactly this LTA is. So I have come up with this video today. So let's see what exactly LTA means. That is leave travel allowance. Okay, take the leave and travel the world. This is, I'm not saying, this is Income Tax Department is saying to you all. Okay, so let's just talk about what is LTA, how to claim this LTA exemption, and how much LTA you can get it. All the rules and regulation we are going to talk in this video today. So watch the complete video from start to end. If you are getting the LTA, if you can see that component in your salary slip, you can watch the video and get the understanding towards that. If you are not getting in the salary slip also, then also you watch so that in future, if you want to add that in your salary, the financial year when the increments will be happen, you can discuss with your employer like, I want to add this component in my salary, and you can put that in your salary slip. Okay, so watch if you want to understand on this topic completely. Okay, watch the complete video from start to end so that you will come to know what exactly this LTA is, what to claim this exemption, and how to get this LTA. Everything you are going to get to know on this video today. Okay, so let's just start and see. See, LTA is nothing but it is an expense cover given by the employer to an employee. Okay, to cover their expenses, travel expenses. This is one of the component which is present in your salary breakup or the compensation breakup. But usually it doesn't falls under your CTC. It is out of your CTC, which is non-CTC payout. It is mentioned separately in your salary breakups. Okay, this is not comes under CTC, but sometimes it will fall. But usually it is not comes under CTC. It will be non-CTC payout. Okay. It is having income tax exemption based on the Income Tax Act under Section 10 of 5. Okay, LTA received by an employee will not be a part of his net income of the year. Keep this point in mind. Okay, it is your non-CTC payout. So now let's see what are the conditions to claim this LTA. Okay, see, to claim this LTA, travel is must. Without travel, you cannot claim this LTA. Travel is must, and next is only domestic travel is allowed. Third is, along with you, your family and your dependents can travel and claim the exemption of it. Okay. Now, 3 points I have discussed, right? First is, travel is must. Second is, domestic travel. What do you mean by domestic travel? Only within, let's say you are in India, then within India you can travel. You cannot travel like international. International travels is not exempted in LTA under the Income Tax Section 10 of 5. Okay, only domestic travel is possible. That too, if you travel through flight, then economic fare of Air India, that can be exempted. That too, economic class, not the business class or any other classes. Okay, if you travel via train, then first class train ticket, you can get it claimed. And if you travel through bus, then deluxe fare of any bus can be claimed. Okay. And one more condition is shortest route possible. It is mentioned like shortest route possible. Now let's talk about eligibility on LTA exemption. See, eligibility is actual travel cost. Okay, it is not like you're spending some money on food or hotels, whatever you're going to spend apart from the travel cost, that is not going to claimed on LTA. Okay, only actual travel cost is going to claim in LTA. And second is, exemption is limited to only the amount which is given by the employer to an employee, not more than that. For example, let's say your LTA is mentioned as 10k in your compensation breakup. Okay, now you're traveling somewhere, let's say for example Mumbai to Delhi you're traveling, and your expense is somewhere around 7k or 6k. Okay, this is first example I'm telling. First condition example I'm telling. If your travel ticket shows only 7k, then only for that 7k you can claim the exemption. Okay, without any tax. Rest 3000, that will be get added with your salary, and the tax will be deducted from that much amount. Okay, second condition is, if you're traveling from Mumbai to Delhi and your ticket rate shows 11k or 12k. Okay, but they have given you only 10k, then only 10k will be claimed, not 12k. Okay, that 2k whatever you have done extra, that you need to pay from your pocket, and you need to travel. So better to travel with less or the exact, not more than that, if you want to claim the complete amount. Okay. And third condition is, if you're traveling from Mumbai to Delhi and your LTA is 10K, then your tickets also, and your ticket also shows complete 10K, then you can claim the complete 10K without any tax deduction. Got it? I hope you are clear with this. I hope you got the clear understanding towards it. Okay. Now let's just talk about the block of year to claim the LTA. This LTA is available only for two journeys in a block of 4 years. Got it? Let's say now current running year is from 2018 to 21. 18, 19, 20, 21. Block of 4 years, 2 journeys you can claim. Got it? Let's say you have traveled for 2 journeys, but you have not claimed. You have done 2 journeys in the block of 4 years, like from 18 to 21, but you have not claimed that LTA. One LTA you have claimed, one LTA is remaining. What you can do is, next block of year, you can claim that remaining one LTA. Got it? Only for the first year it is possible, not with any other. Let's say you have traveled in the block of 14 to 17, like 2014 to 2017 you have traveled, that you want to claim in the block of next block, like from 22 to 25, that is not possible. Okay, only for the first year, only claim it in the next year. Got it? But make sure that only you can claim if the employer is providing the benefit. It is not like you're going to fill in that tax while you're going to file the tax. That time without having the LTA, you're going to claim that. No, that is not possible. If you have that benefit, if the employer is provided the benefit to the employee, then only he or she can claim that LTA. Without that, we cannot claim it. Okay, that component should be present in your compensation breakup. Then only the employee can claim the LTA. Okay, many of them ask me like we don't have that LTA mentioned in our compensation breakup, but can we claim during the tax filing? No, you cannot do that. If the employer has mentioned the LTA to you, then only you can claim it. Else no. And also in the block of 4 years, only 2 journeys can be claimed. Who and all can claim? You, your dependents in the sense your family members. Let's say you're working, then your dependents are your spouse, 2 dependent children and 2 dependent parents. Okay, only these peoples can be added as your dependents and can be claim the LTA. Okay, and travel is must to claim the LTA. You need to take the leave during your working period. You need to take the leave and need to travel, then only you can claim this LTA. If you are not traveling also you can claim it, but the thing is you're not going to save the tax. The complete tax need to be paid, then you can get that LTA amount. Let's say you are having the LTA of 10K, you are not traveling, you don't want to travel, but still you can get the amount. Only thing is tax will get deducted and you can get that amount. If you travel and submit the bill, then the tax won't get deducted. Clear? Just keep these points in mind. So someone also commented me saying that we are not traveling, we have not traveled, or we have traveled but we don't have any proofs to submit. So will our LTA get elapsed? No. Whatever the LTA amount is mentioned in your compensation breakup, that will be get paid to you. But the thing is the tax will get deducted and the remaining amount will be paid. Got it? One more thing is you need to submit the genuine bills. You need to submit the proper bills. Like if you're traveling through air or flight, you need to submit boarding pass or the invoice of that ticket. Okay, if you travel through train or bus, then also you need to submit at least invoice or the ticket. Whatever the ticket you will get, the same need to be submitted. Got it? I hope you got some clear understanding towards what is LTA, how to claim it, how you can get it. Everything, I hope you got some understanding towards it. Okay, I hope you found this video very helpful. If yes, what you have to do, you know already, you just need to like the video, subscribe to my channel and stay connected with me. Also don't forget to enable the bell icon so that you'll get notified whenever I upload any new video. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.